I would take the proximal portion here, or the large piece, and apply it adjacent to the proximal ulna shaft and then fix it there with a screw. So notice how our first screw just went bone to bone and did not go through the plate. We call this a lag screw. After our lag screw is secured, we can now apply the plate onto the surface of the bone. We want the plate to be long enough where we can get at least three screws on either side of the fracture. After the plate is applied and we know it's long enough with three screws on the proximal and distal ends of the fracture, then we can basically drill and fill our remaining screws. So we'll do at least, again, three above and three below the fracture. And the reason that we want three screws both above and below the fracture is that's going to be a strong enough construct to help control bending of the bone along with rotation of the bone. So here is a picture of a ulnar shaft after getting plates and screws, or what we call open reduction internal fixation. And it shows an example of a lag screw in the middle of the construct, along with a long plate that was long enough to accommodate three screws both above and below the fracture. I think this is exactly the pattern that's going to be used for Jared Cannonier's ulnar fracture.